Welcome to a recorded webinar entitled Simply What is Birdseed? How to 4x your website leads using a virtual concierge. Today's webinar is going to be led by myself. My name is Drew Sheehan and I'm the founder of Birdseed. Really looking forward to spending a few minutes with you here and understand that your time is valuable. So we'll try and move through the content as quickly as possible so we can respect your time. What we're going to cover in today's webinar, the majority of the things we're going to talk about are related to the why behind Birdseed. So we're going to talk about who Birdseed is best suited for, go over our story and the problem we believe we uncovered, and then make the case for Birdseed as a solution for that problem. We're going to then talk a little bit about how to customize Birdseed for your needs, go over our plan and pricing options, and then we'll show you how to get started and set up your engagement panel. So the first thing is who is Birdseed made for? Well, the first dynamic are what we call the three M's of websites. Those who make websites, those who manage them, and those who market them. This can be on behalf of others as an agency, or this could be for your own organization. And you could just cover one of these or maybe all of them. So if you are someone who builds, someone who edits and adds on to, or someone who finds customers for websites, you are considered one of the three M's. Now, going forward, we're going to use the nomenclature of websites, but just to be clear, we are also referring to other digital assets, such as sales funnels and landing pages, things along those lines. So the second dynamic of who we believe Birdseed is made for, anyone who uses their website as the moment of decision, right? If it's a crucial step in someone deciding whether or not they're going to move forward with your product or service. Now, this could be a purchase, right, monetarily. If you're ordering a product, starting a service, signing an agreement, maybe you're going to shop in a store or eat at a restaurant, booking an appointment in home or maybe on location with a business. But it could also be non-monetary, right? This could be whether you're trying to find new attendees for your church or get new members for your clubs, get more students for your school, or signups for a newsletter. So there's a number of reasons, but as long as you use your website as a crucial moment of decision, if that is the step in which people decide, am I going to move forward with this organization or am I not? That's the second dynamic. The third dynamic is simply you are someone who needs to have the playing ground leveled, right? We are typically building Birdseed for smaller businesses. Those that have limited resources, those who have just a small amount of team members to attend to and manage their website. If you have some sort of budget, your money doesn't grow on trees for you. And if there's a limitation of time, whether it be to set up products, to manage products, to add tools to your website, if you're limited by these things, right, the things that we see typically enterprise businesses don't have to worry about, because they're going to do whatever it takes. We feel like these are the things, the best customers for Birdseed, those that have limited resources. So if you're still here with us, right, if you fit into those dynamics, we'll just talk a little bit about our story. So I used to own a GPS fleet tracking business, right, where we would track company vehicles using GPS devices. We placed them in their trucks and vans and cars, and the business would know where their fleet employees were, where they were going, where they had been. There was routing efficiencies, safety, a whole bunch of really important value that was derived from those devices. Well, we found that the majority of our business came via our website. This was about 7 years ago, so we weren't doing as much, you know, Facebook, Instagram. There wasn't much advertising going on there, but a lot of search marketing, SEO, things to drive traffic for people who are looking right to our website. Of course, there were also referrals. And oftentimes when, let's say, one fleet manager would tell another, they would, of course, go to our website. And in fact, that really was oftentimes the only way they knew how to get in touch with us, right? That was the only place they could probably find our contact information. The goal of our website was always to increase conversions. You know, the numbers, everyone always uses industry standards of 3%, 5%, whatever it is, it's low. And what you find is that for a lot of companies, you know, they can do everything to drive qualified traffic, right? People that should seemingly want to move forward and buy, you know, your product or your service, but the numbers are always low, and they were for us. And so we would try and find different ways, different tools to increase those conversions. And so, you know, the big thing back then was live chat, like it still kind of is today, even though there's more options. And we would just find that even though we would switch different live chat providers, we'd go to, you know, to different options that maybe looked a little better, seemingly functioned a little better, it really had no appreciable effect on our conversion ratios. So we thought to ourselves, well, we need to figure out what's going on here. And so the problem we uncovered was when we started to put ourselves in our customer shoes. We started to think about who was coming to our website and what was their thought when they arrived. What was their mindset when they arrived on our website? And I'll just tell you to kind of, you know, skip ahead a little bit. That is kind of the goal of what our product is. That's the thing, kind of the core value of what Birdseed is. You know, so if you're thinking about this, put yourself in our shoes. Think about your business here for a moment as we talk through this. We would have first those that were too early to interact with us. A lot of fleet managers were really just looking to figure out what was fleet tracking. Was it something for them? They'd heard about it maybe for someone. Could they afford it? Did they need it? You know, how did it work? You know, how did they manage it? So at that point, they really weren't going to be communicating because they didn't need to yet. They still had to understand. They were what we would call earlier in the sales funnel or the sales cycle or more top of funnel. So then we had a second category of people, right? These visitors were informed, right? They knew what fleet tracking was seemingly at this point, but now they were trying to decide, is this the route I want to go? Oftentimes it was specifically with us versus a competitor. It could be based upon price. It could be based upon credibility. It could be based upon a number of factors that were really important to the decision-making process. And oftentimes it would really be, you know, to not even be necessarily, you know, another fleet tracking company. Maybe it was to just do nothing at all, right? But those type of people also were not necessarily ready to contact us. So then there were people who were ready to contact us. They were ready to ask a question. They were ready to move from anonymous to someone who was willing to give some information. But the thing was, is that if we just used live chat, it wasn't enough because some people really wanted to be able to get on a phone with us. And oftentimes they want to do it quickly. They want to make it easy on themselves. So we had to have different options for ways that, that they could communicate with us based upon their needs and preferences. The final piece was also really crucial and something that I think we hadn't thought enough about and oftentimes other organizations don't think enough about. And that is that even though we were open what we thought were very long hours, right? 8 to 5, 9 to 5, 9 to 6, Monday through Friday, it was 40 hours a week. But our website was open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and potentially was, you know, creating customers for us or could be finding customers because people could visit, you know, at any time. And so if we didn't have something that engaged them where they could respond immediately at that point, we ran the risk of them having to leave. There was nothing they could do if they couldn't take a next step. And so we understood that we needed to offer something for over 70% of the time when we actually couldn't respond real time. And of course, there were also times, by the way, where two other factors came into play, right? We would be too busy to respond even during regular business hours because we only had a few salespeople, or they would come to our website, but they were a little too busy as the visitor. Maybe they looked at it and said, hey, I'm ready to potentially ask a question and move forward. You know, I know what the product is. I think I want to go with these people, but you know, right now I don't have a lot of time. So we needed to have a way for them to take action quickly. So I know we deep dived on this one a lot, but it's super crucial to understanding the why and the problem behind Birdseed. So let's actually go to the numbers for a second and think about why this is so important, okay? As a business, you're always trying to increase your revenue. Now, again, let's just say it's a non-monetary you know, organization that you run. These numbers don't necessarily attribute directly to revenue, obviously, but the premise still applies. Let's say you have 1,000 website visitors, and let's just presume they're all qualified, right? They're someone who could buy your product or service. Right now, you have 1,000 people coming to your website, and of that, you're generating, let's go with oftentimes the industry standard of 3%. So you're generating about 30 leads. Of those 30 leads, let's say you're closing 20 sales, right? About 66%, okay? Now, for our purposes here, we're going to just throw $100 at each sale. So let's say we have $2,000 in revenue, okay? But let's say we are trying to increase those numbers, right? Because we always want to do more. And, you know, frankly, we know the full opportunity here is 1,000 website visitors could or should buy, right? Except for that the real world says that some of these people, you know, there's a lot of factors why they won't purchase. But the point is that there's an opportunity to sell more, to convert more. So let's just say we wanted to double our revenue from 2,000 to 4,000, but we only wanted to change one factor. Let's think about what's most likely and easiest to do. Well, the first thing is we could put another 1,000 visitors in our funnel, right? Drive another 1,000 visitors to our website. Well, the first thing I would say is that traffic oftentimes is not free. Even if you are driving traffic by SEO, it still takes a lot of time, and there's a dollar amount attributed to driving and finding that traffic, right? But certainly there's other ways that there's a direct cost to driving more traffic. The other factor is that frankly, we're usually trying to tap out as many resources as we can. So oftentimes we've already kind of found all the places we think we can drive traffic easily. So that is not necessarily an easy way of doubling a revenue. Let's go to the other side and talk about, you know, increasing our sales conversions, right? Once someone's contacted us. Well, first of all, 66% is actually pretty high. Again, because, you know, there's a number of factors when someone does contact you. Maybe they just can't buy. Maybe there's a reason why, you know, they were a lead, but they just weren't a potential sale. But even if you could increase those numbers, looking at this right here to double our sales, we would have to go well over 100%. And obviously that's just not possible. So we look at the middle, right? The middle option of converting more of a website traffic. When we think about this, we're only at 3% currently, and we want to bump that up to 6%. That still means that 94% of people are not going to be contacting us, but we're also doubling our revenue just by increasing it from 3 to 6%. It's incredibly drastic. And so that's what we're talking about today is how do we bump, you know, in this example, from 3 to 6%? How do we find more of those people? Before we get into, again, our solution, let's talk about a few factors that kind of come into play here. First of all, everything over the last 10 years or so has moved online. Now, you know, depends on what exact time frame you're looking at, but let's just use rough numbers. Let's say the last 10 years. What that means is that consumers are much more informed, right? And because of this, when they're online, when we're online, we expect to find information. We have so many resources in which to derive that information, whether it be through social media, through YouTube, through just content in a search, if there's a website that provides that information. So when a consumer comes to your website, we assume that they are either already relatively informed or that they will be able to find that information quickly on your website. So we have to have resources available to make sure that they can get the information they need. The second thing is that there's also, at the same time, a lot of things fighting for their attention. We have more things kind of coming at us these days, right? We have kids, we have other, you know, social media. We have a lot of things going on in our lives. And because of this, that also means that we need to pique the interest of our visitors a lot quicker. They don't just have 30 minutes, an hour to sit around on a website and just go through every page and hope that they find what they're looking for. And oftentimes, if it's not incredibly quick, we run the risk of losing them. In fact, there's a website, it's sweor.com. They have a lot of statistics that are current on the state of website engagement, but they've got a quote that says it takes about 50 milliseconds, 0.05 seconds, a 20th of 1 second for users to form an opinion about your website that determines whether they like your site or not, whether they'll stay or leave. Now, this is incredibly important because even if it's not a 20th of a second, that sounds crazy. Realistically, that means that probably within the first 5 seconds, 10 seconds, you may have your next customer or not. Let me say that again. In the first 10 seconds of seeing your website, you may either have a new customer or not. It's that important. Oftentimes, they need to be able to find that information, and that may be the only information that they need to make the right decision of whether or not they move forward with you or not. So it's incredibly crucial. Now, the last year or two, in 2020, 2021, going into 2022, we've seen a couple other dynamics that have come into play as well. Everything has moved online as well. Now, what I mean by that is that businesses that were even traditionally brick and mortar were forced to go online. They were forced to go digital. In fact, even a lot of businesses that still wanted to stay brick and mortar had to have other components of their business go online. For instance, if you were a restaurant, because you couldn't open, you were forced to use your website as kind of a takeout opportunity, right? For people to purchase food from you. So even the traditional brick and mortar that wants to stay that way long term still had to find a portion of their business. So everything has been forced to find a home online. The second part is that we as a society have been forced to become comfortable with informal video, right? We're comfortable now and accustomed to seeing people in their homes, but we're also placing a real need and a real opportunity on being able to visually meet someone, even if we're not in the same place as them. We've seen this in every part of our lives, everything from schools, everything with business, even the court systems, our judicial systems are using everything on Zoom. So that's another trend that's come into play. So let's talk about existing engagement options that people use on their website today, right? We've got three most common ones here. Now, spoiler alert, all of these work to some degree. In fact, you either are using them or have probably thought about them, on your website. Now, obviously, you might have a phone number or a simple contact form as well. So those are pretty standard. But I'm talking about other ways of engaging people. So let's talk about pop-up forms, right? Pop-up forms are used all over the place on websites these days. They either pop up in kind of a modal so that you can't move forward on the website. It's like the only thing you can see all of a sudden. Sometimes it's on the corner. Sometimes it's triggered on a specific page. They can be incredibly powerful, but of course, they're only for a certain type of person who's ready to take action and give you your email address. But the other problem is this. Really, all they do is simply collect information, right? They're not giving anything to you. They're just getting information from you. The other thing is there's no real-time communication and connection taking place there. So now let's talk about live chat. We've already kind of briefly gone over this, so we won't spend a ton of time. But those that are still just gathering information aren't going to use live chat. Those that don't want to use live chat obviously aren't going to. And it, of course, requires for someone to be available for live chat to work. So there's limitations in live chat being kind of the sole engagement tool. What you've seen probably because of what I just mentioned with live chat is the rise of chatbots. Before I go into the problems I see with chatbots, the first question I would ask you, and it's what I think about all the time, have you ever gone to a website and actually used a chatbot? I can tell you for me, the answer is absolutely not. In fact, oftentimes I think that frankly, the business is kind of disrespecting me by, trying to almost pretend as if a real person's there. It feels as though they don't value me. But maybe that's my own personal opinion, and everyone has obviously their own opinion. So let's say you have used a chatbot and you're okay with it. Well, the limitations there are that obviously, unless there's a takeover by a real person, there's no real-time communication. There's no real-time interaction with an actual human. It's typically a poor experience because one of two things happens. You either have a multiple choice, kind of like a choose your own adventure where you can walk down a path, or you have to ask questions the right way to kind of start interaction with it. Either way, both of those can kind of leave you frustrated, right? If you don't ask the question the right way, or maybe you didn't get the right information you were looking for, but don't know how to start over or don't know how to get to whatever the questions you were looking for, the experience itself can just leave someone wanting more. And at the end of the day, the whole goal, frankly, is to just be a FAQ, right? A knowledge library, or to collect information, right? So that someone can get back to you. And they just, you know, oftentimes do it in a way where they're pretending as if there's a conversation, but there's nothing real about a conversation there, since conversations take place between humans. Okay, so what is a concierge? As we start to get into our solution for better website engagement. Well, a concierge has typically been found in hotels in the past, right? It's a valuable service. Frankly, more higher end hotels usually offer them. But what do? They allow you to make reservations. You can book services. You can purchase tickets. They provide recommendations to you for certain things. They'll answer questions, a whole bunch of different things. Why are they valuable? Well, because they help you accomplish things faster. You have a real human being that's able to get value, to get information, to take action. They deliver individual benefit. The person who wants to book service, right, might be completely different from the person who just has a question about how to get someplace. The person who wants to make reservations has a completely different need than the person who might want to choose between a show that night. So it's always individual to the user that's there. They also extend the overall value, right? Oftentimes, you know, you think about a hotel and, you know, you get a room, right? You get a bed to sleep in. And, you know, if it's a resort, maybe you get a pool. But there's not a lot of value in a ton of hotels because, you know, it's relatively standard. This allows you to actually extend the value of your time there. And then the last part is that it creates that human connection where oftentimes it's very limited. You know, the person checking you in might be the only person you ever greet while you're in that hotel otherwise. So it gives you one more opportunity to, you know, as a touch point, you know, to have a human connection. So in our case, what is a virtual website concierge? Well, what does it do? We take up to 12 tools and we build them and add them into one customizable panel. Now, you certainly don't have to have all the tools, and we'll talk about that here in a moment, but up to 12 tools. Immediately available from any page, accessed through what we call a launch button. Meaning it's always available, but never in the way. So you provide multiple options that people can choose from without cluttering the experience. What also allows you to do is keep separate your content from your engagement tools. So if someone can access and see what you have from a content perspective, they can check out, let's say, the top menu. And then from an engagement, those quick little things that allow you to take your relationship forward with the organization, you can keep that separate. So also, what can the website concierge actually deliver? Well, it delivers value at any stage in the sales cycle because we're offering different options. It allows you to delight every visitor no matter when they visit, meaning if you're available and it's during working hours and there's options where that you can communicate real time, or if it's after hours, there'll be other things available. It allows the person to communicate in the way that they prefer and that they see fit. And oftentimes, because we include videos, we'll talk about in a little while here, it provides real human interaction. So as we mentioned, there are a whole bunch of tools built into Birdseed. We have a completely separate video on the specifics around each of the tools. So I'm not going to go into that here. Obviously, this has already been a while. We have a few more slides to get into. But the whole point is there are a number of options you can customize to match your brand. But what I will talk about is the categories. We've already mentioned this, right? We have early stage visitors. Those that are just trying to gather information still. We have a knowledge base, a video showcase, and a link launcher. Let's say those visitors that have the right information, now they're trying to decide on which route they want to go, whether it's with you or another option. You can show them client testimonials. You can connect with them through event announcements. You can use our user feedback tool. Then when someone is ready to communicate with you, they can live chat with you. You can provide your phone contact information or offer the ability for them to request a phone call real time. And also when you're not available, they can schedule a call with you for later. They can provide an email address to get something from you in exchange using our email capture tool. And then obviously we have a contact form. So how do you build your custom engagement panel? Well, you can make it incredibly unique to your organization in 6 very quick steps. First, choose a brand color. We keep it very simple. We keep it very basic intentionally because we want to feel native to your website and your brand. So you pick whatever your dominant color is that you want to use for the engagement panel. You only choose the needs that are really valuable to your business. If you already have a calendar system, there's no reason to use our meeting scheduling tool, right? You can use Link Launcher to actually link right to that within your panel. You do this, you show certain tools based upon ability. As I mentioned before, if your hours of operation are 9 to 5, you can turn off live chat and so that there are other things visitors can use after hours. You can also group tools so that it doesn't look like there's just 10 tools sitting there for someone to choose from. You can organize them however you see fit so that the first question that you ask, the first thing they see might only be just a few options to get started. You can also highlight a tool or a group so that something can stand out if you really want someone to see that. And then of course, as you can see here at the top of this panel, you can make it really custom to you if you choose by adding your own logo, adding some text, things along those lines. So how do you customize the Birdseed experience? Well, the first way is through video. There's increased engagement through video. 3 specific ways that we do this: proactive messages, including video throughout the product, and instant video responses. So let's dig into each of these a little bit more. The first one is proactive messages. And proactive messages are a way for you to welcome and guide your visitors. As you can see on the right-hand side, they're a combination of media, which could include GIFs, pictures, videos. They also can include text and links to each of your tools, specific tools, however you want to do it. You can use them on different pages. You can use them at different times based upon whether you're available or not. You can show them to just, let's say, desktop, just mobile, new visitors, old visitors. It's incredibly customizable in terms of who sees them. And you can have multiple proactive messages throughout your account. Here's examples of kind of 3 different ways of building a proactive message. So you can see visually kind of how they would look. As I mentioned, we include video throughout, right? So the first ways, the first thing to mention is that there's a lot of different ways that you can add video. Not only can you embed easily from YouTube or Vimeo, and if you have custom embed code, you can display it there, but also you can actually record directly in your browser. And there's a couple specific ways you can record those videos. The first one is tool introductions. So for our live chat tool, our email capture, and our contact form, you can actually record a short video introduction. As an example, with a contact form, instead of just making it 5 questions that somebody, you know, has to give you some information, you can have a personal message from someone with your organization telling them who the message is going to, who's going to get back to them, why they should send it, and just letting them know it's not going to go into the void. You also can add a human experience to other tools. Each of your knowledge-based questions can have a video answer. Our video showcase tool, you can do video demos, right, of your products and shoot them right through a webcam. We also have our event announcements tool that if you want to talk about upcoming things or recent news, you can do that right directly within the product. Live video chat is exploding, right? So that's kind of transitioning into our solution here. Live chat video is everywhere these days, right? We've seen it. There's a ton of products that have come on the market, especially in the last year or two. But there are a couple challenges with that as it relates to anonymous website visitors trying to have a live chat with you. Now, it works perfect for 2 people who know each other. Maybe even if they don't know each other, but it's set up and it's scheduled and it's ready to go. But when it comes to someone coming to your website and starting a video live chat, there's a couple things that come into play. Well, for the visitor, they may not have a webcam available, right? They just may not have one that's working and ready. The second thing is they just may not be comfortable, right? A lot of times we want to stay anonymous while we're just asking questions. So we don't necessarily want to give them information. And usually it may not be worth it because they just have a quick question or two. They don't want to set up a meeting. They don't want to jump on this phone call and feel obligated. But also it's hard for the business, right? They may not be camera ready depending on where they are and in the environment they're in. There's really no way for them to know for sure what's going to be seen or heard in the background. There's also no easy way for them to qualify the call to decide whether or not they want to take it, right? Is this someone that they want to jump on a video chat? And in fact, they can easily get stuck on a live video chat that they didn't really want to be on to begin with. The bigger issue is this: if someone just talks a lot and has a lot of questions and they weren't expecting it, there's no way for them to do anything else as well. So they are all of a sudden obligated to a live video chat. It can be incredibly intrusive. So what we have, and we actually patented years before the pandemic occurred, was instant video responses inside of our live chat. You can literally add a live human being or a real-time human being without all the things we just mentioned, right? What you do is you hit a button, you record a video. If you don't like it, you just hit record again and send it. But then it actually gets pushed directly to the website visitor in the chat. There's three common ways people use this. One would be when they want to begin a chat, right? To create that personal welcome and starting out the live chat. They can answer complex questions with empathy. So if somebody has a question that really, it would help if you explained it with your voice and for them to see you, you know, over 15 seconds or so, better than text would, that's another opportunity. And then also, it's so easy in a live chat, when somebody gets their question answered, they just move on, right? They're just gone all of a sudden. So this allows you to kind of prompt someone to take their next right step, but it's by a real human. We don't like to just say no to someone who's right in front of us. So it creates an opportunity for someone to take action. We also have a mobile application as we start to talk about value of the product. The value here is you get real-time notifications for any form submissions. We have a number of tools where people submit information. You can see all those inbox submissions as well. So a contact form or someone who schedules a meeting. You can actually have real-time conversations, right? Live chat with your visitors. You can also take a call request right there in the mobile app. And as I mentioned, if you're on our pro plan, you can actually do instant video responses. And then of course we have this available for not only Android, but also iOS. So there's a number of ways to respond to form submissions, but let's first talk about the things that people submit information into Birdseed, right? If they have a live chat request and you ask for information ahead of time, if there's a contact form, obviously they're gonna submit information. There's a call request that might just be a phone number or it might be some other information you're requesting on the front end. Scheduled events to know exactly what they wanna have the call about. And then obviously the email capture so that you can provide them with whatever they want in exchange for their email. So the ways that you can respond to a form submission. Well, first of all, you can bypass Birdseed completely. You don't have to use us for that. So for instance, if you have a contact form and you want us to just link someone right to the contact form on the website, you can go that route, right? We have our link launcher, as I mentioned earlier, a calendar, tool, things along those lines. You can also reply directly by email, right? So anytime that someone submits an email, let's say for the email capture, if they include an email address, you can actually respond to the notification we send out to your company and reply directly to their email. And then the final way is we can connect you to a product called Zapier. If you're not familiar with that, Zapier is essentially a product that creates very custom connections between applications. Currently, there's actually over 2,000, actually close to 3,000 applications now on their platform. What Zapier does, as we're talking about here, is, as I mentioned, it allows you to connect our product and send this information to all of the different applications that you're currently using, right? So it allows you to customize your experience. It takes about 10 minutes to set up. They do offer a free plan. And even their more expensive ones are like $25 a month and allows you to really customize where all of your information goes. We have three real-time options. As we mentioned, our live chat request and transcript, and then our call request, and three asynchronous options: our contact form, our email capture, and the ability to schedule a meeting. We have two partnership programs we want to tell you about. We won't go into a ton of details here, but we have other information on those. The first one is our referral program. You get your own custom link, and as long as you share that with anyone who you believe Birdseed would be of tremendous value to, if they click on that link and then they purchase from us, you get a 20% ongoing portion of our revenue. Everyone wins, right? We also have an agency program where agencies who have customers that they create and manage websites on behalf of, they can add in their own accounts, they get discounts, and it allows them to really manage all of their accounts in a better high-level way. So we have an agency program as well. So let's talk about briefly our plans and pricing. So we have a free plan that you can start on, includes one team member. We call it our Essentials plan. The biggest limitation here is it's for the up to the first 1,000 of visitors per month, and then it turns off until the next month, right? The tool hides. We do have limited branding right on the bottom of the panel, but it's not anything that's obtrusive. So if you're not looking to pay anything, but you want to have a really, really powerful tool, because we include every tool there, our Essentials plan is perfect for a very small business that has little traffic being driven to it. But if you want to bump up, right, our Plus plan has 3 team members included. We don't have any limitations on the number of visitors that you drive to your website. And whereas we actually showed the history of some form submissions for 30 days on our Essentials plan, we actually have the full history on the Plus plan. Excuse me. You also can remove that custom branding at the bottom of your panel. For those that really want kind of the full deal, that would be our Pro plan. And we jump from 3 team members up to 15. And we also provide those video responses and live chat as we talked about. So the pricing for the Plus plan, if you pay annually, is $29 per month. And our Pro plan is $79 per month. It's a little bit higher if you choose to go monthly. Our product is absolutely built for small businesses, right? We've tried to make it super simple. There's no add-ons, there's no gotchas, there's no other cost to our product whatsoever. And we tried to make it affordable, right? So when you look at our product at $29 per month, for the majority of organizations, keeping this super simple is an additional lead that we might be able to help you generate through your website worth $29 to you. And for our Pro plan, is it worth $79? That's the question you would have to answer for yourself. So in terms of getting started with Birdseed, it's super, super simple. You can get Birdseed live and a whole bunch of tools active on your website in about 15 minutes. You just sign up for your completely free account. There's no credit card needed. You can choose the tools and organize them however you want. You then customize your panel in the way that we talked about, and you simply add one line of code to your website and it's live. It's super, super simple. Here's what I'll leave you with today. 3 questions. The first thing is your website really important to your sales process? Maybe you haven't thought about it, but the majority of people that come to your website, is it an important moment of decision that they are making when they visit your website? I can't answer that for you, but it's certainly an important question to ask. Do you think about the mindset and the needs of your different visitors? Do you have you thought about what they're looking for when they visit your website and what they need for them to be able to take their next right decision? And the final question is this: if you understand the first thing and the second thing, is your website currently meeting the needs for all of your website visitors, for the different types of website visitors? Do you have the different tools to engage them properly in order to maximize your leads? Thank you so much for joining us in this webinar, and we look forward to hearing from you soon.